Good morning, students. Today we are going to start the new chapter, chapter number 13, motion and time. So motion means movement. That means object moves, and time means the duration or the moments in which the things happens. So motion is related to time. We say that object is in motion when it changes its position with time. So we say that object is in motion when it changes its position with time. So in this chapter we will study about the motion and time. So come first to the chapter 4. So there are the main topics, that is slow and fast motion, uniform and non-uniform motion, measurement of time, graphical representation of motion. So first of all we will see the activity. Activity is given: observing the motion of the path. That means we have to observe the movement of the path or the road. So draw a straight line on the ground with a chalk and ask some of your friends to stand a meter or 2 meters away from it. Let them roll a ball gently along the ground in a direction perpendicular to the line and note the time taken by the ball to come to rest. So that means you have to draw a line straight and keep your friend 2 meters away from it, from the line, and ask him to throw the ball perpendicular, means 90 degree angles, and let them push the ball in a curved path. Now after pushing the ball in a straight path, now push the ball in a curve. Curve means slightly, not straight. That means up and down should be there. So curve means circular, little circular, not straight. And then note down the observation. There will be some variation. The motion followed are rectilinear, straight line motion, and the curvilinear motion. So there are two types of motion: rectilinear motion and curvilinear motion. So write down your observation in the table given below. For the rectilinear, time taken may be 4 or 5 minutes, and for the curvilinear it may be increase or decrease. It might be 5 to 7 or 8 to 9. So that means according to the path, the time taken will also change. So motion and time are related. So you have already learned in class 6, when the position of an object changes with respect to time, so it is said to be in motion. We also learned about the various types of motion. That means motions are mainly of 4 types. That is, number 1, rectilinear motion. Number 2, we have the circular motion, underline rectilinear motion. Then we have the circular motion. Then periodic, oscillatory. Now remember, periodic and oscillatory motion are same. But number 4 will be rotational motion. So rotational motion is not written. So you will write rotational motion in the book. So spelling will be R-O-T-A-T-I-O-N-A-L, rotational motion. So there are 4 types of motion. Rectilinear motion. Rectilinear motion are those motion in which objects moves in a straight path. Example, when the soldiers do the march past, even when a car is moving on a straight path, that is called as rectilinear motion. Number 2, circular motion. Circular motion, the motion takes place in the circular pattern in the form of circle. So example will be when you move in a merry-go-round, or when you move the pedal of a cycle. So that is called the circular motion. Periodic motion or oscillatory motion are same. Periodic motion, when the motion repeat itself after regular interval of time. For example, clock. In clock, motion is repeating at regular interval of time. So that is called the oscillatory motion. Even the swinging of pendulum. Have you seen the pendulum? Pendulum swing. It moves to and fro in a periodic motion. So periodic motion means the motion which repeat itself after regular interval of time. It is also known as oscillatory motion, because in this motion the object oscillates. Example will be swinging of a pendulum, or even the seesaw. Have you sat on the seesaw in the very seesaw, the what happened? Just up and down. So there is a back and forth movement. So that is called periodic motion. And last is the rotational motion. Rotational motion means in which the object moves, rotate on its axis, on a fixed axis. The object moves in a circular pattern. So that is called the rotational motion. For example, the ceiling, the fan, the blade of the fan moves on its axis. Even the earth rotates on its axis. That is called the rotational motion. So there are four types of motion: rectilinear motion, circular motion, periodic motion, and rotational motion. So in this chapter, we shall learn how we determine whether an object is moving slow or fast, and how do we measure the time intervals. So in the next class, you will study about the slow and fast motion. So that's all for today. Write the notes and learn about the motion and the type of motion.